This afternoon, we are here at the Microsoft offices in Prague, and we are about to watch a startup competition organized by the company SeedStars World. And I'm going to take advantage of having all the jury members in here, and I will ask them one question. And the question goes like this. What is it that you need to see in order to say, yes, I'm going to support you. I want you to win.
So as an angel investor with product development background, I look at the product first. Does the product have anything different that will make it stand out on the market? Secondly, I want to make sure that the team is the right team and can they execute on the things that would be required for the product to be successful on the market. And it's different for every product depending on the stage of the market or the nature of the business. And then lastly, you know, and a lot of startups tend to forget about that. Will I make money as an investor? Is it a business that can scale enough that I will make some money? Because that's why I'm here as well.
So the three things I look for when I consider making an investment are quite easy. And the most important one is, of course, the team. I need to understand that the team knows what it's doing, that it's capable, that it has drive, that it has passion. And they need to show me that they can actually execute on their vision. And on that note, they actually have to have a vision. They can't just have a cool technology. They need to show me that it can attract certain customers. They need to show that they can actually grow that vision into a real business with a real return to an investor as well. And on that note, the market size, the market opportunity has to be big enough as well. I'm not saying it has to be global in every case. There are very, very attractive opportunities which are more local. For instance, I'm an investor in a Kosovo company that is very local, but potentially could be the first unicorn in the Balkans. So, but it needs to show that there's a market opportunity there. And if those three things are in place, then I think it's a very good case for making an investment.
So I think the three things I look for when I judge a competition like this, the first one that comes to mind is really whether you can tell the passion about in the pitch, in the voice of the founder. He has to really be excited by his own idea because he's going to embark on a pretty long journey, and if you can't feel him excited about it, it's probably not going to work. Mm-hmm. The second one, obviously, is whether it's an interesting product that they've developed, whether there's something unique about it, whether there's an unfair competitive advantage. And the third one that's quite important is whether it's addressing a big enough market, because there's plenty of great ideas out there that deserve to exist and that will probably be quite successful businesses, but they'll be more what I would call a lifestyle business, generating nice revenue. Whereas as a VC investor, we look for the businesses that have the opportunity to really kind of explode and really grow exponentially. So that's the third thing I would say, whether the market is big enough.
I think conviction is very, very important, because if you don't have conviction, you can't stick it out, and no business plan is always correct. So you have to have conviction. It can't just be a business. It has to be a thing you really want to do here. Absolutely has to be. Money follows that. Second is to be very clear that you have a plan to actually use the money you're asking for. Companies are very good at asking. They're taught how to ask very well. They are not necessarily always well equipped to deploy funds once received and to monetize value. So I listen to that. And the third is the ability to actually understand that the business is more than the founder. So to put the business and the operations capability ahead of one's own ego and balance those things for growth. Those are the three things that are important to me.
There you have it. Based on these interviews, here's your list of five must-haves for your next pitch in front of the investors. I hope it serves you, and please don't hesitate to ask. I'll be very happy to help.